Hello, welcome back to Father of Two Plays The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. Last time we spoke with the Bloody Baron, and he had us investigate the disappearance of his wife and daughter in exchange for hearing about the whereabouts of Cirilla, who came through here. We ended by talking to Gretka and returning a toy that Ciri had made to her.
All of it.
Everything would not quite be, or isn't quite, what it seems, I think. The Baron's daughter doesn't want him to, or she wants him punished. And it looks like there was violence in the bedroom.
Looked like you got soused last night, too.
Yeah, I didn't. But thanks anyway. We also bought a map, maybe it was last time or the episode before. We bought a map that will lead us to some Witcher treasure or Witcher armor, possibly. I didn't quite catch what that guy said.
That's an outing to find that sheep.
Bring the smiths, lads. Get two squad men to you.
Nice
tips on
that. Talking about the shrieker. Wreaking havoc in the
our bitch birthed a litter. We have a new batch of pups, 5 of them in all, small and spindly, but enough to make a stew of. I'll sell them for a few crowns each or exchange for other food. Soothsayer, honest and true-sighted. I've many a year behind me, and have been through much in each. In return, the gods have granted me the gift of sight. I need but to take a hand and gaze upon it, and before my eyes comes a vision of what awaits that hand and its owner, and all it touches. Some call it witchcraft and unnatural, this gift, but to my reckoning, it's the same as how some swim strong or play fiddle masterfully while others sputter and screech. If you do not fear knowing what fate has in store, come pay a visit to old Rakche? Our bilberries died. My daughter, Bilberry, a lovely girl, and the apple of her eyes, died this year, the fourth of her short life. We buried her in the graveyard by the crooked birch. Whoever wants to place a lump of earth or light a candle for her, that's where to go. Oh, sad. Gwent, looking for new players. The Sharpers, a Gwent-playing society based at Crow's Perch, is looking for new members and opponents. Experience preferred, but will also school newcomers to the game, but not return any coin lost during training matches. For more information, see the club's chairman, Philip Stranger, known as the Bloody Baron. Oh, we might have to just head right back there and play Philip. Fistfights, any man who wants to test his manliness by slugging it out in the ring, come see us and you'll get to fight the best brawlers around. Smithy, Stan Fishgulper, Jonah, and the Sergeant. The Sergeant's the guy we followed when we showed up here, I think. Horse races. If you haven't heard, we race horses around here. Anyone wants to join, come talk to me. I'll fill you in on how it works. But I'll tell you right now, you gotta pay an entry fee to race, so if you're skint, fuck off. Radko. Oh, I should have taken that one. Okay. Let's head back and play the Baron at Gwent, then. And then we could maybe start fighting. We'll have to look at our quests and see which ones are for what level and decide what we want to do next. But first, since Gwent isn't really about level, we're going to play the Baron. Let's give a quick save here, in case he robs us blind. Alright, Philip.
I'm listening.
Mind if I call you
what
Phil?
What do you come to me with?
I want to play Gwent.
Ever play Gwent?
I do. And what's more, I usually win. If you've a deck, sit down. Outplay me, and I'll give you one of my unique cards. How's that for enticement?
Oh, very good enticement indeed.
Let's lay him down, my man.
Yeah, let's lay him down, Geralt. Okay. So, I don't want to add any of these cards. Looks like we're good to go. He goes first round. He's also the north. I guess that makes sense. Okay, we have a spy. We have one of these guys. He's not the best by himself, but let's trade out that guy. And Sabrina. Okay. So, we'll start off with a spy. And maximize our cards. I mean, not bad. And he's got a spy. Ah, but I have a decoy. You thought he was your spy. But it was all a ruse. Yeah, those are not the best cards. Like, there's no sense having them if you could have three or four of these guys, because the chance of getting, you know, these guys is downed by having a bunch of those 1/1s that get tougher for, or double for each other one that comes out. So why not just have these and have a better chance to get more of those guys? They could get really powerful. I think you could get four or five of them. So, we might be just letting him win this one. But, why not just play at least one card, because we can revive, right? Yeah, let's play that, and then we could also take out his whole front row, basically. So you're going to torrential rain me. I have a clear weather. We're going to biting frost you. And now we're winning? No. But we're barely losing. Okay, I can revive him next round. That'll be handy. Any more? Yeah. Now we're winning. And he passes. So we pass. And we take that round. Plus, like I said, we can revive the spy that was put out. Stennis? Yeah, that's nice. Okay. That's a good thing. Okay, it's our play first, so we're going to play her and revive this spy. Hopefully we'll get another decoy. Nope. Oh, but we did get a third one of these. Okay. Well, we got two clear weather, so let's make him think that we're heavily invested in the back row here. And see what he does. He's got to win this round, right? And I don't think he has it in him. But we'll slow play and we'll see what moves he has. We'll try and delay our moves, our big moves at least. So we'll play everything before we even clear the weather. Everything for that row, that is. Pardon me. Okay. But they're actually fairly tough without, or with the torrential rain. Yeah, let's clear weather. I think we've won. Like, I'm just gonna go all out here, unless he has something amazing. I mean, that's a decent play, but it's still not enough. Not enough unless he has something. Yeah, not enough for you, man. So, my game, and I get that card. I mean, look how tough they are. Okay, so they get times by one, or, yeah, one, two, three, as you add more. I get it. Still, very tough. And then if you doubled them with a commander's horn, they'd be 24 apiece. How do you like that, Philip?
You won. A man's only as good as his word. Take the card. I fear Velen's short on worthy opponents. Boatbuilder in Oriton might be one. There was also an old soothsayer. Lived east of here, near the windmill last I heard. There's a lad, about as reasonable as an old mare, but he plays a devilish hand. In fact, I don't rightly know that you're ready for him.
Okay. So we got a new quest for Gwent cards. And what do we get for a card? Ooh, Dijkstra. We might as well add that now so I don't forget. Another spy. Excellent. Oh, and we'll have a little jump there. Jump for joy. Let's get Quen selected, just in case. Pardon me, I'm still getting over a cold. It's been like a couple of weeks.
Got eyes like a cat. Catch mice.
We could check our quests. Witch hunting, that's level 5. Secondary. Funeral pyres, that's level 3. We could go finish that up. And Shrieker's level 8. So let's finish up funeral pyres. We might be able to quick travel. We want to check the shops anywhere we go. Try and get the maps. Okay, good thing I have another controller just waiting nearby. I better grab it, though. I guess you guys must have seen that my controller's low. I apologize. I don't like to charge them till they're dead, because it's better for lithium-ion batteries, which I think these are, to get killed all the way before they are recharged. I guess depleted is a better word than killed. I use the word, you know, died about electronics so much that now my son asks if they died and asks if other things died, so I'm gonna have to explain death a lot sooner than I wanted to. But he needs to know about it. Okay, so we could go to the Hangman's Tree. Was there any shops in Muldrydale? I don't believe there were. Inn at the Crossroads has new... We might as well stop in here. And then we'll quick travel to the Hangman's Tree. And go finish up this... quest where... I'm pretty sure this is the one where the priest... is dealing in Fistech and tried to kill the competition. Okay, let's take a quick look. A plea. Okay, we've read that. Read that before. Read that before. Okay, that was kind of pointless since they all were things we had already read and none of them was like a quest or anything, but fair enough. We got two places to check along the road here. I suppose we could do that. There's one that's definitely right along the path, but they're both probably around our level. It's hard to tell or to know before you show up. So let's go to our world map here and maybe we'll mark this one and go check it out. We need to buy some alchemy stuff and make our other potions and stuff like that. In fact, let's just check our alchemy real quick. So, I need some water essence, some more arenaria, some spectre dust. Got a lot of oils I can make. Why can't I craft that? Oh, I can't do it on horseback, I see. Beast oil, hybrid oil, vampire oil. Well, let's brew up a couple of potions, or oils, I guess. Beast oil, yes. Hybrid oil, yes. Decoctions. Noon rate decoction significantly limits the duration of knockdown, hypnosis, stun, and blindness. Okay, we'll make that, and we can make a bomb. Devil's Puff Ball. Okay, let's do that. We need one more calcium equum. So yeah, we should visit a herbalist when we get a chance.
Run, Roach.
And try and make as many of our potions and such as possible. Let's just cut through here. What do we have, like a mine or something up here? Let's find out. Oh, got level 6 knackers. Okay. that's a little bit dangerous. They're ogroids, I'm pretty sure. So, don't have any oils for them. Why don't we take a quick... Oh, shoot. Come on. Don't get in the way. Horse. Roach. Roach, you're totally in the way, buddy. Please stop running in circles. Okay, so... Yeah, let's go into our bestiary here and take a quick look at what Neckers are weak against. Northern wind bombs and Ogroid oil, okay. Nothing we can field at the moment, so we won't worry about it. Got more up here. That's a warrior. He makes the others tougher on the earth. And he is tougher himself. I think they attack better with him around. Okay, let's drink this apple juice. Use a thunderbolt. Get our Quen up. Shit. Ooh, that was close. Quen. Ooh, I got hit in the back almost there. Okay, get the Quen up. Drink the apple juice. Ooh, close one. Thought I was gonna eat it there. Alright. Start feasting on raw meat, I guess. Might as well equip our new bomb. So we got one dose of potion left before we definitely should rest. Okay. Well, that wasn't the worst. Gambeson. Perhaps I should upgrade until I get some Witcher gear. Let's see what it looks like. Plus one armor. Its resistances aren't as good, or there's not as many. Yeah, I'm gonna stick with my Witcher gear then. Okay, let's get our Quen going. Suent mushrooms. What else is in here? Okay, it looks like it goes deeper. Got some chests here. Ooh, meteorite ore. Or superior ursine. Hello. I can't even make that. Gotta need the lower levels first. Okay, we got a warrior right off the bat. Come on, guys. Oops, I frickin' poisoned myself. Smart. Okay. There we go. Try and keep our Quen. There's a lot of them. It might not be too wise. Unless I could get a couple at a time. Come on, warrior. I don't want to fight all of those. They'll kill me, for sure. Come on. Get him with the heavy. Yeah. Nice. Okay, one down. Whoop. Okay. Next. Okay, that's not... not where I want to be stuck. Oh, he's got poison on, he can die. Come on. Swing to break through their attacks, nice. How many are left? Four? Okay. Can't dodge anywhere, you're stuck on the wall. Okay. Three more, two more. Three more. Poison. He's gonna die. Oh, not quite. Okay. Another one down. Two left. We need to just get in here now. Yeah, alright, one left. Where you at, little guy? Is it glitched out or something? Oh well. Ooh, lesser blue mutagens. Now, I think if we go into alchemy, we make another blue mutagen. We don't have enough. I guess we need two more. But I think we have one more. Like, we have two. Yeah, one of them's equipped. Yeah. Okay, fair enough. Hopefully he deigns to grace us with his presence eventually, or just stays down there, I guess. Fire. A cauldron. I don't Neckers did that. Oh, runestone. Not bad. Oh, another couple chests. Insectoid oil. Okay. What else? Relic oil and dancing star. Let's go to our alchemy again. Bombs. Dragon's Dream we can make. We need sulfur. Okay. Good stuff, though. All in all, that was a good trip. One worth saving, I think. Is it auto-saving? Oh, maybe it's that enemy that's under the ground. And won't come out. Well, that was worth going in for. I mean, if not just for the ingredients, for the, what do you call them, alchemy formula? Okay, there's another marker right around here. There it is. Bandits, perhaps? I see some tents and stuff. I see a guy on a horse, too. Yeah, a couple of guys on horseback. Definitely bandits. Let's get our flame going again. Nice try, buddy. Okay, next. Sounds like we got dogs or wolves over there. Wrong. Wrong thing. We got an archer somewhere. Okay, let's see if we can use some bombs here. Just dragon stream. Okay, we'll try it. Do I have hangman's venom? No. Well, if they're level 9 dudes, eh? Okay. Horseback guy! Ooh. Okay, that's one guy down. Gonna need R to get that guy off. Have a recording interruption. I happen to be able to hit the key while fighting. Got an archer back there. Let's see if we can't make him hit his buddy. Nice. Okay. Twen. Well, I hope I didn't miss too much of the fight when the recording got interrupted there. Oh, okay, we'll use that. Igni. Igni is what we're getting. Oh my god. Coming up from behind, huh, buddy? That's not very nice. There we go. Oh, I thought it killed him. I was waiting for the death animation. Alright. Let's, get Axie on. Oh, another horseback guy. Oh, crap. We're gonna wait till we have some art going and hit him. Alright. Oh, nice. One hit kill. Ready, buddy? Sorry, my timer's going off here. Oh, I set him on fire. Nice. Get Axie. And get behind him. Nice. Beheaded. Okay. Oh, a cage key. Excellent. That was quite the fight. It might be, I should have used up my, my last Thunderbolt on those guys. Then I would feel okay about resting. I mean, I'm just anal and I don't want to waste one potion use, but I probably should just rest. Alright. Oh, there's a sack here. What's that? Unsent letter. My dear Helk, Helki, remember when you said, Easebor, don't you go robbing folk, the gods don't like it, and besides, only refugees on the roads these days, and they're even poorer than us. How you were cross that I shirked working in the fields and didn't bring a scrap home to put in the pot? Well, you're gonna have to eat those words, my dear. Gobble them all up with a hearty slice of humble pie and some baked crow on the side. Yesterday we cornered this merchant. And not a Gore's Velen or Brenna man, but from Nilfgaard itself, you see, from the city of Golden Towers. Didn't speak much common, but enough so's we could understand each other. He said he was carrying some goods to the Blacken's camp. We took everything he had, and I'm telling you, Helki dearest. I think that's supposed to say dearest, but that says dearest. You've never seen so many crowns in your life, nor could you ever hope to count that high. Now we're going to rough him up a bit more to make sure he hasn't hid some of his gold or goods. Once we cut off his thumbs, he'll spill the beans about any extra treats stashed in the soles of his boots. And once Mirko scalds him a bit, he'll tell us about the precious stones he's got sewn in the feed bag. might tell us a great many such things of interest. In fact, you never know just what till you try. Tell the youngins Da's going to be home soon. That'll bring them toys and treats. And they'll eat so much honey cakes their tummies are going to burst. For you, Helki, I bring a silver necklace and brooch. Because, while you could be awful cruel at times, I still love you, you naughty bint. Easebor. P.S. Throw on that nightshirt with the lace and red beads for my arrival, and color up your kisser somewhat. I feel a bit bad, but... I just killed all those guys, and he wanted to go home to his kids. They're all starving.
I'll make an exception for you.
I bet you will. Yeah, I feel a bit bad, but they tried to kill me. Like, they didn't give me any choice, really. Well, until next time, if you enjoyed it, please leave me a like, subscribe if you want to see more, and leave me a comment. Let me know what you thought. This is Father of Two, signing off.